Hey everyone, welcome to Aftershoot. My name is Justin, and today we are going to go over how to build your AI profile using Aftershoot Edits. So to get started, you can click on the upper right-hand corner. You'll see the plus new profile button here. So I'm gonna click on new profile. The first thing I need to do is just name that profile. So we'll just name it test for this sake. And the next thing I wanna do is actually just choose whether I'm using RAW or JPEG images. What this means is what I actually shot and edited with. It's not what I exported to, but rather the actual files that my edits are applied to. So if I imported raw images into Lightroom and used the sliders to adjust the raw images, then I need to select raw. Whereas if I imported JPEG images into Lightroom and made my adjustments on the JPEGs, then I would select JPEG. The other thing we need to do is actually determine whether or not we are going to use a color or black and white profile. We only do one or the other because what we'll do is automatically ignore images that are black and white when you choose color, and vice versa. If you choose a black and white profile, it'll ignore anything that's not been converted to black and white. The next thing I'm gonna do is actually choose the Lightroom catalogs that I'd like to use. So in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and just select a couple of catalogs here. We'll just pick three catalogs that I would like to train on. You can add up to 15 different catalogs at any given time. So in this case, we're just gonna use three, but I could do 15 if I wanted to. And then the next thing I'm gonna do once I have these catalogs here, I'm gonna click on continue. Now we do recommend using smart previews. Smart previews are something that you can build within Lightroom, and this will help speed up the process because what it does is prevent Aftershoot from having to make its own DNG conversions of your files. Now that I've clicked on continue, you can see I'm here on my screen where I get to filter my images. So I need to tell Aftershoot what it needs to learn from. What are my actual finally edited images? So in the case of this first catalog, I'm gonna clear the filters here. I'm going to just select these three different categories. These are my collections that I created. So I have three collections available here, and I'm gonna ask it to only look at the 5-star images in those collections. I'm gonna head over here and go to my next catalog. And in this case, I actually wanna select all of the images, and I'm gonna clear my filters, and I'm gonna go, these are all the folders here, and I only want the 5-star images from those folders. And then lastly, this third catalog here, I'm actually gonna select all the images, and I'm gonna select all the filters because everything in this catalog is edited. So then I'm able to just simply click upload, and these will head up to the cloud, and a magical unicorn will be trained and sent back to my computer in order for me to edit. So if you wanna learn how to edit, you have to tune into the next video to learn how to use your AI profile once it comes back to you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and be sure to check out some of our other videos to learn what Aftershoot can do for you.